The drop means you go down on your left or your right knee. You go down on your left or your right knee, and you can use it as a counter attack, or you can use it as a direct attack. So in example, against cut number one to my head, I lower my body down to the right knee and thrust like so. Okay. I can go a little bit forward into my thrust, okay, or I just drop on the spot where I'm standing like so. Okay.
When I use the technique of the drop with a cut, I use a cut number one. From an open guard, I just go down on my right knee a little bit forward and cut down with a small motion of the hand, of the wrist. Okay? Very quick. The power in the cut comes with the dropping motion into my opponent. And when I go down on my right knee, I can also use the drop with a cut going on my left knee. So in example, I feint with a thrust to his face, he raises his touch, and then I go down on my left knee, and then I have also a deeper attack, a wider attack into my opponent. Okay. Really important is to stand up again. Okay. I don't want to spend too much time on the ground, because if I miss my attack, if I miss my cut, okay, it can happen that my opponent rushes into me and just throws me on my back, and here I'm nearly helpless like a bug. Okay? Of course I can kick, I can cut, whatever, but it's not the optimum position. So the moment you lower your body for the drop, you should think about standing up again. So when you use it with a counter thrust, go down. After the thrust, if you miss or if you thrust him really deep into the body, you stand up again, moving forward, using your touch to punch or to push away his weapon, and then you can go forward with another follow-up attack, or you have to parry or whatever happens. And the same is after the cut. When I'm going down, the best way is to go to an underarm guard. Okay, I'm cutting down, and now I'm in an underarm guard, and from here I can stand up and cut again with a cut number four. Or this cut is not really a cut, it's more like deflecting his blade and coming with the next attack inside of his defense. Or I can also turn this into just a parry against an incoming attack and then stand up. Okay, so there are many possibilities, but most important thing is you have to stand up again. To defend against this low-line attack, the best way is to use the same idea like we use against any kind of leg attack as we had in the previous lesson. So when he attacks my front leg with a drop, I shift and counter with a cut number two, and then his head is most of the time really exposed. But I have to be really quick with the shift, because with a drop, he can come much deeper into my defense, okay? He can cover more distance, like compared to a regular leg attack. He can really go deep inside, and he can come really deep inside my defense, and when he stands up again, he's pretty close. So he can cover a lot of space between him and me. So even if I shift my front leg, it might happen that he cuts my other leg, which is then my front leg, okay? Because I cannot really well see what distance he has, okay? Is he cut like this, or is he going on the left knee and steps into me much deeper, okay? So keep that in mind. We will show some examples of the techniques, of the situational techniques, when you use a counter thrust with a drop, or when you use a cut with an attack on the drop.